Morning children, today we will see the grammar topic if clause, which is also called as conditional clause. We'll see the definition of the clause. A group of words which forms a part of sentence and contains a subject and a predicate is called a clause. So a clause is a part of sentence which has a subject and a predicate. The clauses are divided into two kinds, main clause, subordinate clause, which is also called as independent clause or dependent clause. If clause, as I told you, is a conditional clause, so it is a type of subordinate clause. It is usually linked with the main clause and with the conjunction if. So let's move towards if clause. In the first video we have seen the zero conditional. Now in video 2 you will see the first conditional, which exercise is given after our lesson A Gift of Chappals in Working with Language. So first conditional, which is a possible situation in the future, it means we use this first conditional clause when we are telling about a possible situation which will happen in the future. So condition plus result. Condition sentence will be in the present tense, which is the sentence of if clause, and the result will be in the future tense. So let's learn with the example. If it rains, comma, we will cancel the trip. So what is the condition? If it rains, means if rain will start, then what will be the result of the condition? We will cancel the trip. So a situation that is possible will happen in the future. Next example. If you study, you will pass the exam. Definitely, if in the present time, if you study properly, what will be the result of this condition? You will pass the examination. So, uses of first conditional, a possible situation in the future, predicting a likely result in the future, if the condition happens. Definitely, the result which may happen, which will happen in the future only if the condition happen. Because if the condition will not happen, then we will not get the result. Let's learn with in detail. See, if the condition is in simple present tense, plus the result will be in simple future. Now see the example. If we work hard, that is the condition. The result will be we will finish the project on time. So the first conditional is used to express a real or very probable situation in the future. Probable means what? Which may likely to happen. It refers to the things that will possibly happen in the future if a condition is met. As I said you earlier, if the condition happens, then only we will get the result in the future. The first conditional is common when we are talking about possible plans, promises, warnings, threats, or for persuading someone. To persuade someone means to convince someone. So the uses of first conditional are when we have to talk about our possible plans, if we are talking about the promises or even warnings, or if we want to convince someone, we can use the first conditional if clause. Let's learn with few more example. Condition, result, present simple, future simple. Number one, if I go to Italy next week for work, I will visit the कोलोजियम. इफ आई हैव टाइम टुमारो आई विल हेल्प यू. इफ यू टच दैट वायर यू विल गेट एन इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक. इफ यू सी ऑल द सेंटेंसेस ऑफ इफ क्लॉज दे ऑल आर इन प्रेजेंट टेंस एंड इफ यू सी द सेकेंड हाफ ऑफ द सेंटेंस विच आर द रिजल्ट ऑफ द एक्शंस दे आर इन द फ्यूचर टेंस. वन मोर थिंग दैट इज अंडरलाइन विथ रेड दैट इज द कॉमा. मीन्स इफ वी आर यूजिंग इफ क्लॉज इन द बिगिनिंग वी हैव टू यूज कॉमा टू जॉइन द सेंटेंसेस. दिस विल क्लियर टू यू इफ यू विल लर्न मोर एग्जाम्पल्स. सो लेट्स हैव सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ इफ क्लॉज. इन दैट फर्स्ट कंडीशनल क्लॉज, if he studies hard he will pass the exams. If we catch the 10:15 train we will arrive on time. If you don't get the ticket what will you do? If it rains I won't go to the park. If I study today I will go to the party tonight. If I have enough money I will buy some new dress. She will be late if the train is delayed. Now if you observe this sentence, in this sentence I have used the if clause in the second half and so the comma is not used. She will miss the bus if she doesn't leave soon. Again the same kind of sentence. If I see her, I will tell her. If you spit on the road, you will be fined. The last sentence is a warning that if you spit on the road, what will be the result? You will be fined. So, you will be fined is the sentence of main clause. And if you spit on the road is the sentence of subordinate clause. It means if clause. So, understand? If clause is the type of subordinate clause. It needs the main clause to make a meaningful sentence. Let's move towards the textual examples which are given in our Honeycomb textbook on page number 30. Walk fast. You will catch the bus. Now here the two different sentences are given and we have to join these sentences using if clause. So how it is joined? If you walk fast, comma, you will catch the bus. So what we have done here, when the two different sentences are given, we have first identified that which is the condition and which is the result. Definitely, walk fast is the condition. And the result will be you will catch the bus. So we have joined if with the first sentence. If you walk fast, you will catch the bus. Let's see one more example. Don't tire yourself now. You won't be able to work in the evening. If you tire yourself now, you won't be able to work in the evening. Again, these two sentences we have joined with if clause. Study regularly. You will do well in the examination. And how this sentence is joined? If you study regularly, you will do well in the examination. Same is applicable to you also. Work hard. You will pass the examination in the first division. See, both the sentences I have taken related to the examination. In first one, if you do the study regularly, you will be able to write well in the examination. Secondly, if you work hard, what will happen? You will pass in the first division. So here, I have joined the sentence using the if clause, but in the second half of the sentence. You will pass the examination in the first division if you work hard. It means we can join the sentence in both the manner. We can take if clause in the beginning, but we have to use comma if we are using it in the beginning. And we can join the sentence with using if clause in the second half of the sentence without using a comma. So I hope if clause is clear to you, and in that the first conditional clause. Thank you.